Greetings again, everyone, and welcome back to Devil Summoner 2. Somebody was kind enough to post in the comments the location of the final Mahjong tiles, so I went and collected those in between the previous recording session and this one. I'm just gonna turn them in. The person who informed me of this also mentioned that in the Japanese version of the game, apparently completing this quest opens up a Mahjong minigame, but I guess that was removed from the Western release, which is unfortunate, but it's exactly the kind of thing that I've mentioned before when, I think even in this playthrough, I talked about Japanese games being watered down and having things removed from them when they're ported over to the West, for no other reason than that the developers don't think Westerners will understand or appreciate them. And it's one of the reasons why I really appreciate what, at the time of this recording, Koei Tecmo is doing with Neo. And if you're more interested in that, you can just look up Neo and the beta feedback and changes that are being made to Neo. Okay, well, I think we're just about done with all the quests we can possibly finish now. Other than that, which I'm going to have to worry about later. And this, which I apparently can't access. Because I haven't seen any place in the Dark Realm where I can find anything like what they're looking for. And this one, I have no idea. This seems to be a much later game quest, so I doubt I can even access the item. So I guess we're done with quests. It's finally time to move on with the main story. Let's head off to Tsukigata Village. Though I have a feeling that the chief is not going to be especially happy to find that we've been messing around in restricted areas of the village. Oh, yeah. He's clearly not happy. We've been waiting for you. Narumi, Raidou. Oh, for God's sake! You got yourself taken hostage again, Tay? If you don't make any false moves, we won't Akijiro, make up your goddamn mind, man. Are you my friend or my enemy? Pick a side and freaking stick with it. Jeez. Tay, are you out of your gourd, Akijiro? What's all this about? Righto, it was you, wasn't it? I thought I told you not to go near Centipede Road. Dude, we were following Don on your orders. Double standards much? You've seen things no one was meant to see. The Tento... Well, it's not like I'm gonna tell anybody! We can't let any foreigner who's laid eyes on the Tento Lords get away. I propose a trade. You for Miss Asakura. Do we have a deal? You know what? Screw you. I will kill you first, Akijiro. Oh! Look, conveniently, it's Akane! I heard Raidou was coming, but he never showed, so I came here to see what was going on. I heard everything, Father. What are you thinking? If word of the Tento Lords got out, outsiders would be sure to take interest. That would upset the Tento Lords, and if that happens, our village is done for. Akane held some powdered medicine wrapped in wax paper up to Tay's nostril. For God's sake! Is it bedtime already? Boy, I thought these guys were known for using insects in their assassination, but all they've done so far is throw sleeping powder at me. For God's sake! Was that really necessary, Akane? Did you really have to do that? When you wake up, continue as though this were just a bad dream. What is the meaning of this? Father, don't you remember? Raidou saved me from Don. Aren't you ashamed of yourself to take his friends hostage and threaten him? Raidou, tell me what happened. But first, come inside. It's not polite to keep guests on their feet. Yeah, Akijiro! You uncultured jerk! Akane explained the circumstances of the betrayal. Now then, Raidou, can you tell me what happened at the Tento Sanctuary? Oh, Raidou explained the circ... Yup! That's starting to become a really irritating cop-out for maintaining this protagonist's silence. So that's what happened, that damn son of mine. I didn't think he'd be here already. Just when the marriage ritual was about to start, it's as if he's hell-bent on interfering. Akane, Raidou told me. About Tsukigata Village and the Tento Lords, and about the marriage ritual. We know. I know there are reasons behind the relationship between the Tento Lords and Tsukigata Village, but there's something to be said for resisting the status quo. You're entitled to a future too, you know? Even if it is something you learn from a certain young man. I'm very glad to hear you say that, but I'll just accept that you think so and leave it at that. Giving up my life is necessary to ensure a future for Tsukigata Village. I wouldn't dream of resisting the wedding to the Tento Lords. It would hurt the Tsukigata name and the pride of the Tento Crest. Raidou, Narumi, oh, now you look ashamed. I asked you to chase after Don, and if Don entered the Tento Sanctuary, then, of course, unaware of the circumstances, you'd follow him. I went too far. I hope you can forgive... Akijiro! I'll let it slide, but this is the last time, buddy. I'm getting kinda sick of your wishy-washy flip-flopping. It's getting kinda old. Don is here. Things have gotten serious. I need your help. Well, yeah. Don't you forget who's helping you here, Akijiro. You better start showing a little more respect. Can't let the marriage ritual fail, please. I'm asking you too, Raidou, Narumi. Completing the marriage ritual successfully, that's my last wish. Well, isn't she noble? In a kind of depressing, fatalistic way. Afterwards, Raidou and I went after Don to stop him from interfering with the marriage ritual. Oh, so I guess this is just a cutaway with Narumi filling in the gaps. Purely for the player's sake. We worked day and night to scour every inch of Tsukigata Village, but we never found Don. Preparations for the marriage ritual continued, with fears of sabotage hanging in the air. And here we are, the night before the ritual, sitting in our room at the Fukuroku Inn. Looking like this ritual will go on with us knowing nothing about where Don's lurking. One other thing. I heard from the attendant that Tay went back to the capital. Apparently something urgent came up, and the capital daily called her home. One minute the dame was held hostage by a clan of assassins, the next she's eating dinner and getting ready for work like nothing happened. She's one tough cookie. Well, I think more likely, based on the effects of that medicine, it sounds like it just made her forget. Also, the look on Narumi's face. Boy, despite the character art style in this game not really being my favorite, they really nailed facial expressions, didn't they? Speaking of Tay, there's a story she told me once. In olden days, people who could forge iron from iron ore were considered supernatural or magical. Her story was about a group of these people all immigrating to some village. The iron they found made life in the village easier, and their iron goods brought in a lot of money. Everything was peachy between the immigrants and the villagers at first. The immigrants didn't look quite like the normal folks of the village. Humans can be a sad crew, huh? He's not wrong. Once someone's fortune is made, they'll trample over whoever they have to in order to protect it. The villagers started avoiding the immigrants and worried about what the neighboring villages thought. Eventually, the village elder couldn't sit on the fence anymore and sent the immigrants into the mountains. To keep the villagers from following him up there, he started a rumor about the mountain curse. When I heard this part, I could tell the elder wasn't a bad egg. So long as the villagers stayed away from the mountains, everything would work out for the immigrants, right? The immigrants might have been exiled, sure, but they got their peace and quiet out of the bargain. What do you think, Raidou? If you were that elder, what would you have done? Incoming alignment question! Send the immigrants up into the mountains, or put your foot down and get everyone to coexist? You don't have to think too hard on it, just give me your gut feeling, what would you do? Yup, alignment question. I'm not sure which one of these actually serves the law alignment and which serves the chaos alignment. He says I don't have to think too hard about it, but... Unfortunately, the problem that this system creates is that rather, like, once you know how the system works, okay, if you're playing the game for the first time and you don't have any idea how the alignment system affects the gameplay and the endings you get, then yeah, you'd probably be more inclined to answer from your gut. But knowing how the system works, you end up answering in a way that is purposefully attempting to just manipulate the system to create whatever alignment balance you're going for. And I honestly can't tell here which one is going to earn me the chaos points. So, I don't know. It seems more like thinking of a way to coexist would be the law option. And I guess sending the immigrants away would be more of a chaos. I don't know. I'll just cross my fingers and hope. I know chasing them into the mountains sounds a little cruel, but you have to see it as everyone living in the place that's best for them. The relationship went bad, they lost access to iron, and they started to hate the immigrants. So I know it took a lot of empathy from the elder. He upset the status quo to open a path to the future. Okay, then yeah, this does sound like the chaos option. I don't mean to get you down with all this talk, it's just... hearing more about Tsukigata Village and the Tento Lords reminded me of that story. Goodness, have I been blathering on this long? Look at the time! We better take care not to oversleep tomorrow. Wouldn't want to miss Akane's big day. You say that as though everybody should be happy about this. Garen will be there, so I'm not too worried, but... you bet your life that Don will be there, too. Oh, yes. We call the luck that the heavens dole out to us fate. And there's no question that fate plays a big part in our lives. People talk about forging your own destiny, and that's fine as far as it goes, but what if they're fated to try and pull it off? I wonder if our actions in this world will lead to the future we want. Mr. Narumi? Is something wrong? I turned in early for the night, but I couldn't sleep too well. I know you do not necessarily agree with the Tsukigata Village or the Tento theories, but... we must stand steadfast. Your wavering may affect the young ones. Sorry, Gaiden. Didn't mean to cause a scene. Nagi doesn't look too good, huh, Raidou? It needn't enter the bounds of your conjecture, Mr. Narumi. Oh, we're at the Tento Kagura. Okay. What are we doing here? What's wrong? Isn't a wedding usually an occasion to celebrate? When I think of Miss Akane, guess I'm in no mood to celebrate either. Well, all right. Guess we have to talk to Gaiden? No, we just have to approach Nagi. All I can do is sit and watch Miss Akane sacrifice herself. I've never felt so powerless. Even as a devil summoner, I'm unable to intervene in the situation. Raidou, isn't there anything I can do? Master. Nagi, prior to a mission is not the time to express doubt. You must eliminate this uncertainty. How many times must I tell you? You may struggle all you want in theory, but the situation may not change, or will not change. Nagi. Looks like the ritual's about to start, Gaiden. Akijiro's here. Now, I have to wonder how much choice I'm actually going to have in the upcoming events. Whether I'll be able to make any decisions that meaningfully affect the outcome, or whether it's all just scripted. You will wait here. Huh? We can count on Don showing up, but how would he slip past this kind of security? One guy! Well, okay, two guys. Two dudes on security. I'm really glad they take security seriously. After promising yourself to the Tento Lords and swearing yourself to our gods, drink the sake down in 3.5 sips. I will spend my life serving the Tento Lords. This I swear. Well, the sake might not have been the best, but the ritual is now complete. Oh, no, it ain't! There he is. That voice! Oh, here we go. I overslept a tad, but it looks like I managed to make it just in time. Well, it's nice to know that even villains have rough days. The guest of honor ought to arrive fashionably late to get the crowd going, don't you think? Unsurprising. Don, you went through the process of... I really hate the way that Nagi and Gaiden speak. It's really beginning to grate on me. Careful now, Nagi. I'm not the same fella I was yesterday. I hope. What's that supposed to mean? Oh, that's great. Below us. Nagi? Oh, look at this badass Gaiden. Master. Don. Gaiden, if you call yourself a devil summoner, why are you standing there instead of saving Akane from having to marry a monster? Gaiden doesn't seem very happy about the accusation. Well, I'm stepping in, even if it means I gotta go through you. Hmm? Master! Nagi! Pretty fancy footwork, Gaiden. Ain't too many fellows what could have avoided that one. Don't you fret about him none, Nagi. It wasn't a serious shot. I thought we could agree in a process of compromise, but... if it's a battle you wish instead, then there is no alternative. Your opponents will be Nagi and myself. Abandon any theories that you may hold about holding back. Stow it, Garen. You're not the one I came for. I got bigger fish to fry than you. I'll leave the rest up to you. Oh. Bye, Don. Raidou, watch out! Don is on his way. Brother! I'm here to rescue you, Akane, just like I promised. You, and right in the middle of the ritual, no less. You're a disgrace! Well, Dad, I figured there's no need to stand on ceremony when the ceremony is as ridiculous as this. The Tento Lord's rule ends today. There ain't no need to listen to their demands anymore. What the? Heathen! Traitor! I'll tell you the details later, but before that... I got you to deal with, Raidou. Still gonna try and stop me, huh? Well, you got your reasons. Though... I'll be taking Akane with me, Raidou. I got a promise to keep. And I still owe you for that time at Narita's. Yeah, it's all coming back to me now. I'm getting pissed off at you all over again. Brother! Raidou! Too late to back out now. It's already started. I'll peel off every last one of your toenails, make it so you can't even wear shoes without crying. That's an interesting threat. Alright, Don, if you really want to do this. Just reminding you, those tricks you used at Narita's place, they ain't gonna work on me again. Well, that sure is unlucky for you, Don, because I've got new tricks up my sleeve this time. And I even remembered to rest and heal all of my demons. Finally. All right. I do not anticipate Don giving me enough trouble that I should need to summon any demons other than my two Yomi Kagutsu here, although... keep forgetting he's got Poison Smash. Do I, No, I don't have any antidotes, but that's fine. This is gonna be over way before I need them. Ugh, my head is spinning. This ain't exactly going like I planned. We don't have to do this, Don. Sorry, Taramaru, but I need your help to make the best of a bad job. Bring it! Taromaru appeared. Okay. Oh, he's got AoEs. Taromaru seems to be agitated. Gee, I wonder why. Get him, boys! Taramaru is immobilized. Okay, well... later, Taramaru. How dare you make Taramaru cry again? You're on my last nerve. I'll finish you off with my burning resolve. Alright, good luck, Don. Oh. Burning resolve. Oh no. I'm on the outs with the Tento now, and I still gotta beat this Devil Summoner. Becoming King Abaddon sure ain't no walk in the park, but that don't mean I'm giving up! What I'm aiming to do is too important to fail here. I'm gonna give you everything I got. You know, I admire his determination. Oh. Well, rip, Dawn. What? Why? I gotta become King Abaddon! How could I lose here? Ooh, an insect cage. I like that. Oh, so Garen and Nagi beat those guys. How? How did I lose again? It don't make no sense. I went full bore right from the start. I can't believe it. I'm the man who'll become King Abaddon, and I lost? How strong are you? Brother. Akane. You're probably mad at your brother about now, huh? You shouldn't get agitated and shake your leg. Also, you shouldn't scratch your head while you eat. Huh? It'll be okay, Don. I'm your sister, after all. I'll make a good bride. You should go apologize to the villagers and try to be nice to Father. Look, Akane, that thing you made for me, you remember? The cream thing. What was it? The cream puff? Yeah, that cream thing. You ought to make some more of those. I wanted another one. Oh! I remember now. I did tell you that, didn't I? How I wanted to become a pâtissier. Thank you, big brother. Thank you for coming. Hey now, don't cry. It was nothing. Any brother would have... Enough talk from you. You stole my armor and paraded around the capital. Oh, that was his armor? Oh, okay. No matter. You can be buried in it if that's what you want. Ah, jeez. Playing tough guy, huh, Dad? Well, I know the truth. The day Akane was chosen as the next Tento bride, you spent it crying in your room till your eyes went red. Huh? Oh, this old man's still got some fight in him. Take him away. Wow. All right, I'll play along for now, but you know I'm going to have the last laugh. The Pogetron's already finished. Soon the insects will be raining from the sky. The Pogetron? It's the premonition of King Abaddon. I feel it. I wish you could feel it too, but... You'll be safe, Akane. A little later than I planned, but you'll be safe soon enough. Goodbye, brother. Akane should be inside the Tento Sanctuary by now. I locked up Don. A few of the Hukoshi are guarding him. It's finally over. This is certainly the most out-of-control ritual ever. But at least the Tento Lords will be satisfied, and the Tsukigata saved face. It all worked out. It all... worked out. Akijiro! Akijiro, I apologize for asking this during a difficult process for you, but... I wish to see Don. I'd like to test a theory on him. Huh? Please forgive his indiscretions. He is an unfortunate child, much like his father. We will be leaving now. Nagi, resume the process of your self-training. You remember the process, right? Then be on your way. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but I must leave too. There's a lot I have to follow up on after the ritual. On behalf of the Tsukigata clan, thank you for today. Though you were involved in ways I didn't always... Well, regardless, thank you for your efforts. Yeah, get over it, man. You know, Raidou, that man's as unlucky as anyone else around. No father would just willingly offer his daughter up as a sacrifice. But I guess the marriage ritual's done with and things are settled with Akijiro and Don. Guess our work here in Tsukigata Village is done, huh? It's about time we excused ourselves. Wouldn't want to wear out our welcome. Please wait here, guests from the capital. Wait, what? Perfect timing. This must be my lucky day. I want to ask you a favor. The young mistress Akane gave me this letter and told me to hand it to the young master. I have to keep it a secret from the chief, but Don's locked away in that cell, right? I have to go help the chief now. He can't know about this. Could you do it for me, sir? Come on, please. She thrust the letter into Raidou's hand without waiting for an answer. Okay. See that he gets it. Goodbye. Raidou, make sure you don't forget to deliver Akane's letter, okay? I've got to head to the Fukuroku Inn and start getting ready for the trip back to the capital. Say hi to Don for me. Why do I get the distinct impression that I am being used in some kind of scheme to free Don? Well, whatever. I guess I'm going to head back to the inn. You're special, you can pass. Okay. Oh, right. Yeah. Fukuroku Inn. Gonna just sleep off this poison. And I guess I'm gonna buy some antidotes. Cause that's kind of annoying. And I guess, in the meantime, I'm going to wrap up the episode, so thank you all very much for joining me. And I will see all of you next time. Take care, everybody.